And welcome back to part two of Bocage on Let's Play Battlefield 1942. The word was definitely out that I was trying to make my way up there, and someone had an X-Pack that he just tossed down there and detonated. That's even better to use than just tossing down grenades, because you get a much larger blast radius. You also have a bit more control of where the thing actually lands, since the X-Packs don't roll along the ground. Judging by the ticket lead that we accrued, which is massive and probably insurmountable since both sides have uncapturable bases, we really did a good job of maintaining control of this island and the bridges. This doesn't really look like much of an island since it's so large, but I guess technically if it's between two rivers, it's two sections of a river, it's an island, right? Just maintaining control of that bridge and blocking the axis from getting across really gave us a chance to hold on to the bridge flag on the other side, as well as keeping control of the shack flag. So we had bleed inflicted upon the enemy for a very long period of time. One thing that I haven't noticed too much on this round is I haven't really seen the airplanes making much of an impact. And in fact, strangely enough, I haven't seen too much out of the tanks on this map. A couple friendly tanks about, but I haven't seen the enemy tanks really crossing the bridges and making much trouble. It's been a very infantry-oriented round. Since some brave soul on our team managed to get this flag neutral, I've got to honor that and at least try for it. And I got really lucky there because the last bullet in the clip managed to get the kill on that enemy. Okay, so now finally the Tiger tank rolls up just before we're gonna capture that flag. We've got a couple of guys over here. I might want to take out the grenades if I've got any and pelt that tank. Now, I guess I used my grenades earlier. Not much I can do right now. I can't even keep the flag neutral because the capture radius doesn't extend this far. I'm just kind of annoying that tank because he knows I'm down here, but he can't shoot me because of the angle. I don't know if this is a fair trade or not. I'm keeping this tank pinned down, but he's keeping me pinned down as well. Although even if I weren't here, he'd probably be stuck there because of the American tanks on the other side of the river. What I'd really like to see here is a friendly plane just kind of drop by and knock out that Tiger with a couple bombs. Somehow the Tiger tank got blown up. I didn't even see how that happened. There weren't any planes around, and I guess it's possible that an American bazooka soldier managed to get him from long distance, but that's really odd because Tigers have so much armor.
Good job, soldier!
I picked up the German version of the assault troops weapon. You don't see me use these very often because I never spawn in as assault. I guess these assault guns really aren't all that bad as long as you're able to crouch and keep your accuracy up. Otherwise, they just miss way too much. Lucky shot there. You always gotta go for those moving targets though, just for the fun of it. You know, if you miss a moving target, that's fine, you're expected to, but if you hit the moving target and kill him, it really has a demoralizing effect on the enemy. Because when an enemy's standing still and he gets sniped, he can kind of justify it by saying, well, I shouldn't have remained still like that. But if he's running around and he gets headshotted anyway, then the message it sends to him is there's really nothing you can do to avoid getting sniped. And that really bothers people a lot. not much left here to do. The round's just winding down here. It's going to be over in a second. Maybe I'll see if I can grab one of the tanks that spawns in. But overall, the Germans just inferior overall. I mean, they couldn't bring out their tanks, couldn't really do a whole heck of a lot. Their infantry action wasn't all that great. And I don't think there was even one serious attempt by them to sneak a flag capture on our flag that's closer to our main base. So they couldn't get us into a two-front war. Often people will do that with a plane. They'll just bail out and sneak a flag from behind just to break things up. But that is going to do it for playing on the American side of Bocage. Let's play Battlefield 1942. See you on the next episode.